Oh, welcome back to the morning show here on Arise News. I'm Biola Labi.
And I'm Tundra Biola. Our next guest, Kelechi Ogene, is the founder and chief executive officer, GMYT Foundation, an empowerment platform for underprivileged women to learn various aspects of fashion illustration, design, and manufacture through scholarships to her GMYT Fashion Academy. With an executive degree from Lagos Business School and an alumna of London School of Fashion and Lagos State University, where she earned a degree in industrial relations and personnel management, plus several fashion awards home and abroad, it's no surprise that in June 2018, she was appointed a member of the Advisory Board of Nigerian Entrepreneurs Award. Now joining us to discuss the fashion industry and why she set up the GMYT Foundation, welcome to the program, Kelechi Ogene. Good morning.
How are you?
Fine, thank you.
So let's start off by asking, what is GMYT Foundation?
The name GMYT was actually carved from my own name, which is Godsmite. So that's just an abbreviation of Godsmite, basically. Yeah.
So what is it? Can you tell us about what you do?
Okay, so I'm the director of GMYT Fashion Academy, and the president of GMYT Foundation, and the CEO of GMYT African Humanitarian Award. So these are just, maybe I think it's time we start calling it group of companies, so GMYT group, you know, of company. And then, so GMYT Fashion Academy basically is creating the next generation of fashion entrepreneur. I'm a fashion designer, so we train students, the Fashion Academy, so we train students pattern, beading, freehand, art and craft. At the end of the day, they become fashion entrepreneurs. And then giving back to the society, we decided to, you know, create the foundation where we train women that cannot afford the school fees but have passion, you know, for fashion design. So at the end of the day, they go through the same training and also start their own businesses. And then we also have the GMYT SME support scheme where after they finish, after they graduate, but this is not restricted to just our fashion design. After they graduate, you know, we put out 100,000 every month, you know, to support their business. But then they have to, you know, create a pitch, and because we have a lot of students that we have graduated. So as to giving everybody the money, because we're not so, you know, so we decided, okay, you create a pitch, and then you'd like the last question we did for last month was tell us about your passion, your values. We want to know how passionate you are about your business, and how you know, how familiar you also, you know, with your business, your objectives, your value. And then they come, so they make the pitch, and then the winner goes home with 100,000 naira. We've been able to also create our own fashion show. So we also give alumni the publicity, you know, that they need, and also give them that exposure. So we're also, you know, we're also partnering with, like, media houses like you.
Yes. So, one of the things you've talked about is the academy.
Yes.
Where do you find your students? How do they enroll in the academy? And do they pay tuition for in the academy? I'm just trying to understand the financial structure.
Okay, so over the years, yes. So there's a GMYT Fashion Academy and then GMYT Foundation. So over the years, we've been able to graduate over 500 students. So 200 from the academy and then 300 from the 300 from the academy, sorry, and then over 200 from the foundation. So for the academy, students come, they pay, they enroll, and then we teach them.
How long is that program?
So we have 3 months, we have 6 months, we have 9 months, and we have 12 months. So it depends on, you know, the student. They also do their internship. So if you pay for, say, maybe like 9 months, you get 2 extra months internship. So you're spending 11 months with us. And then for the foundation, the students, they come in. You know, we select randomly. They go online, and then they fill a form on our website. And then we choose randomly, you know, based on the words, you know, because they have to give us a reason why we should choose them, you know, we should give them the scholarship. So we choose randomly, and then so they come to the school, they don't pay for the fees, okay, and then we teach them with the same curriculum, same instructor, same environment, security, you know, same curriculum, and at the end of the day, they're able to start their business. And some of them are Amaka Stitches, Root Signature, Remedies Design, you know, so we have like a lot of students. In fact, currently, 4 of our alumni actually have their own fashion academy. You know, some are into production, some are into ready-to-wear line, you know, like shop orders, some are into... In fact, there are a lot of them that are actually doing well at the
so
end of
So you're making
the day.
A huge impact in
yes,
the fashion
yes,
industry.
Yes, of course. Yes.
That's great. Yes. What inspired you to start this program?
So every decision that I've made over the years has been influenced by experience. Okay, so I've been in business for about 14 years this year. Okay, but it's been a journey. So 4 to 5 years now, I'd say, for the academy. So I started from the boutique, and then, of course, it got to a stage where I decided, okay, instead of selling other brands, it was time for me to start selling my brand because, as far as I'm concerned, from what people say, I'm a very good marketer. Okay, so I decided, you know, to start my own brand, which was Gmite Couture. And after that, of course, God has been faithful. You know, he's obviously blessed the works of my hand. And I decided to start giving back. And that was what bettered the foundation. But, you know, people registered, they came in, and then they started training. But other people that were coming, more of the people that came, rather, you know, they said they didn't want to be tagged along the foundation, that they were ready to pay, you know, for the service. And I'm like, okay, if we can structure this program for them so that they can start paying, I think we would then train more people for free, you know. So that was why we structured the academy. So now the academy is the parent company, but initially what we started from was from the foundation.
Oh,
so
wow.
We were training people, you know, for free. And then the academy. So after the academy, I decided, you know, startup usually, which we started this year, the Gmite SSS, you know. Startup, they struggle, you know, because before they break even, they must have, you know, done the business for some time. And that was why I said, okay, let's start the Gmite SME support scheme so that when you graduate and, you know, you're just starting your business, would have some money in place for you to, you know, to support your business. So everything is just being a phase. So there is a point in time where I would now say, okay, this is what is happening. Okay, let me introduce this. This is what's happening. Let me introduce this. So it's been a journey.
So it's been an organic journey for you.
Things have grown
organically.
From scratch, yes. Yeah.
So when you think of, when you look at the SME scheme you have now, who are the partners you're working with? Are you working with other SMEs? Are you working with other organizations that can actually fund people once they finish their training?
Okay, so far, the people who have trained, you know, we don't have partners. Okay, we are looking. You know, we're sourcing for partners. I don't know. Well, what I'm doing is let my work speak for me because I don't really know how to get them. So, in other words, even the people that come to the school, you know, is the alumni that, you know, word of mouth. So they are making reference. They'll say, okay, I trained from Gmite Fashion Academy. You come to the school, you know, or the students are saying, oh, I'm in this school and they have my structure and whatever. So they also bring their friends, you know, their family to join the school. So basically, with over the 200 students, you know, that we have even currently, is word of mouth. It's the students that we have, you know, that and the alumni that we have that also bring in them. So hopefully, the more people we train, you know, and them also going out to say, oh, this lady trained me, we finished from this academy, you know, hopefully that will attract the sponsor that we want. But I'm not just waiting for the sponsors to come, you know, I'm doing all the things that I need to do, you know, and then I'm waiting for the works.
You're putting all the right structures in place.
But you really must have such a great service because very rarely will you hear a service being offered for free and people offer to pay for it. So
yes.
Well done.
Thank
you. So you brought this brochure with you?
Yes. So we have, like I said, we've been able to also create a platform where during graduation, you know, the students get to showcase their brand because we also want the world to see, you know, what the process, the training that they have, you know, gone through. So we create this platform where the media houses also come, you know, to interview the students. So it's a proper fashion show, actually. Mm-hmm. And then the students are modeling their brand because I tell them, as a creative director of your brand, I wear only my brand. So you also have to
wear
your
brand. So this is your brand?
Yes, this is my
Very
brand,
nice.
Gmite Couture. So the students are modeling their brand and marketing their brand on the runway. And then, of course, we invite other guests, you know, to come see. Of course, enjoy the show as well, but to come see, you know, the students that are graduating. So the students not only make their outfit, but they also create minimum 5-piece collection that they will showcase on the runway. Like the last graduation that we did, they all created bridal collection. We graduated about 85 students in December,
wow.
In November, sorry. And then they all created bridal collection on the runway. And then on that day also, they get certified. Okay, and then they're on the red carpet, you know, also marketing their brand. So another thing we've been able to create is the entrepreneur session. So they are not just learning the cutting and sewing, but also the business aspect of it. You know, so aside me taking the entrepreneur and the business session, like last month I did passion and entrepreneurship. And we also invited, you know, some other entrepreneurs like Yeni Shitukem, branding. And then, so this year we already made arrangements for them to take sessions on customer service, marketing, and, you know, the problem that startups face. So aside that, every month we're creating, you know, entrepreneur sessions for them to learn the business aspect of it, marketing, structuring, planning, budgeting, costing, how to even cost for a particular outfit, you know, fabric analysis, textile. So they're learning the business aspect alongside learning the practical aspect of it.
So what's exciting for me is really the stuff you go into in your curriculum. You have pattern drafting, yes, freehand, you have manual fashion illustration, you have accessory beading, you have fascinator and hat making classes, you have master classes, you do entrepreneurial sessions. Yes. And if we can get the camera to just see this is sort of an example of some of your classrooms where you actually have people at sitting down at sewing machines, sewing and making making things.
Bag making, bead making. So we're teaching them art and craft. Like Yemes Sauvignon now, you know, from the art and craft class, she's been able to, she now have her own brand. So aside the bespoke outfits that she makes, she now makes like beautiful bags, shoes, you know, that she's also selling, like beautiful, nice hampers that she sells, you know, from the art and craft class.
So what does it feel like for you to have all this impact and also to see these new brands and businesses that started as people that came through the course?
Yes, one thing is I'm trying to leave a legacy, because at the end of the day, you know, like this morning I got a message, you know, I'm from one of the foundation alumni in Amaka's Teachers. She said, God, because she saw the GMIT's SME support scheme, you know, this month we're giving out 300,000 to entrepreneurs. Yeah, so, and it's not a loan, you know, it's just come make a pitch, what will 100,000 do for your business? And if you're the best, you know, you get to the fund. And then she said, may God continue to bless you and send you support and sponsors. And, you know, just as you have groomed me, you know, prayers like that, words like that, you know, encourages me to do more. And money can buy that. So at the end of the day, I feel more fulfilled, you know, training the foundation student. Yes, I feel fulfilled with the alumni of the academy as well, because they're doing very well. But the foundation student, knowing that they didn't pay anything and they're able to stand, you know, I just feel more fulfilled. And if you know my history, you know that I keep thinking of ways, you know, to support women, girls, making them independent, you know, structured, you know, and I don't know. I'm feeling like mother of many nations.
Really great.
Thank you. So here we also give industrial machines. Last year we gave about 95 industrial machines. You know, and that's what we also use in school. You know, so we're giving them machines to, industrial machines to also go do like their homework, and then also, you know, when they're graduating, so that it's easy for them to start.
So you've mentioned a few of your brands. You've mentioned Amaka Stitches twice in particular. But is there any outstanding success story that you're
particularly there's actually a lot of them. There's Casa de la Mor. She has her own fashion academy as well. There is Root Signature. There is Digo Fashion Academy. There is Alips Fashion Academy. There's so we have like a lot.
And these are all your alumni.
Actually, alumni. Yeah, so we have a lot of them here. Okay, so there's Beauty Green, there's Casa de la Mor, there's KMOD, there's Yemes Signature, there's AB Stitches. Oh, and then during graduation, the best student also left, the last one left with $300. So I wish I could do more, but, you know, it's just me doing all these things, and I'm doing them, you know, in bits with what I can.
You don't have any partners?
Yeah, no partner, no sponsors. I've actually been doing this on my own. So we actually have a lot of them. There is House of Light. So we have students in business and we have alumni in business. So what we're teaching them is, you know, to start their business before they leave the school. So we're teaching them how to start small, you know, and that's why we're also, you know, thinking of how to also support them with a little fund, because I know it's not easy to start. First, as an entrepreneur, you won't be on salary, so it's really not easy. Mm-hmm. So you have to work before you get the money. So we're teaching them how to be diligent, how to be dedicated, how to be focused, you know, how to also structure, you know, and then at the end of the day, we're seeing results. I mean, there's PG Trend, No One Signature. There's actually a whole lot of them. If I start mentioning them, we'll go out.
I just wanted to understand, how many people a year do you have the capacity to graduate from the program and also from the academy, from the foundation and the academy?
We can. So last year, we did. We trained 86 women for free just last year. So we have done over 200, like I said. Now, from the structure I know we have, this year, we just started a new project of training 500 women for free. Now, with the capacity that we have, that's just for daytime students and the weekend students, we can comfortably do the 500. But if we have sponsors or partners, you know, we can do over 1,000. All I need to do is just structure the program, probably start having evening classes, you know, and all that. But we have the capacity. We have over 50 machines. We have, you know, the security. It's and then we also have hostel accommodation.
You have, you know, for the
students.
Where are you based?
As well. Lekki Phase 1.
Oh, wow. You have, yes, hostel accommodation.
We have hostel accommodation. We have, you know, the school as well, which is literally structured. And the environment is, like, very conducive. You think you're overseas.
Nice. Yes. What are the greatest challenges that you face in the with the GMITE project?
The fact that we don't have sponsors, I mean, I want to do more, you know, the fact that we don't have partners as well. I want to do more, but even if they don't come, this is passion for me. So is what I'll continue, you know, I will definitely continue with the project. So finance, you know, fund, because we have a lot of team that we're paying salaries a lot. And then we have, you know, we're burning diesel. we're spending close to like over 300 and something thousand monthly on diesel. And then I think that's it. So finance, power, and then...
There are quite a number of organizations out there that are focused on helping people build vocational skills. Some of them are local, some of them are international. Have you had any of them sort of come and partner with
you on this?
No, so I guess that could be some opportunities as people are watching today, that people can come and partner with you.
Oh, that would be nice.
Another thing is that there's the Lagos State LSETF Fund for people that actually want to start their business, and they give loans between $500,000 and $5 million, and that's for people that are setting up businesses in Lagos. And so maybe some of your graduates could also tap into that funding.
Okay, so I've seen, I think it's CLEF. Mm-hmm. I think I've seen, you know, that program.
Yes, LSTEF.
Now, what I am doing is training them. If I can actually get them, like the people we've trained, I don't know them. So if I can actually get them to send me the candidates to train and then probably fund their kids, just their kids. They don't have to pay for the school fees, just fund their
kids. Okay, that could be a very
good partnership. That would be very nice. And the scholarship I'm giving them is 1 year scholarship. So at the end of the day, before 1 year, you would start seeing results. So what I want is partnership. If they can partner with us, it would be nice. But, you know, I don't want the loan where we start paying back.
No, it's not for you. It could be for your entrepreneurs.
Oh, okay.
And these could
be
small loans for them to start.
For them to start. Yeah. Oh, okay. That would be nice, yeah.
But now looking at fashion entrepreneurship on a larger scale, where do you see it going and how do you see... Do you see it really addressing or helping to address a lot of the problems that we have in Nigeria with unemployment, especially youth unemployment?
Yes, of course. I mean, with the number of students that we have graduated that have started their business, they won't be waiting for white-collar jobs anymore because they are now CEOs of their company. You know, the only thing is that they'll be struggling to build it as an entrepreneur, but they are now CEOs of their company, so they have more time, you know, to also structure their family and also balance the life.
How far are you taking your fashion entrepreneurship? What are your future plans such that other people can look at that and possibly follow?
Well, we are creating more jobs, which is one. We're reducing unemployment. We're also contributing to the economy. And then we're making women and girls become more independent. So we're also reducing crime because now we have some youths, you know, some men that applied for the foundation that have started. You know, so the students that we have graduated, like the ones that have started their own fashion school, not only are they creating more jobs, okay, but they're also teaching, you know, students to become entrepreneurs. So I think we're actually doing a lot considering...
Do you have plans to take this out of Lagos and to eventually export to other countries at some point?
At the moment, no. But the students that we are creating, the entrepreneurs that we're creating, you know, they are... Of course, they're doing all that. So I see them as my branches. Really.
And then your own boutique. How many boutiques do you have?
I did the boutique business for 9 years. Okay. And then after that, I stopped doing the boutique.
Okay.
So then the couture phase and now the academy is the parent company.
So how can people get your designs?
I'm a bespoke designer. I do I do just bespoke. So what we're also teaching the students is to carve a niche for themselves. So aside having a fashion academy, you can be a bespoke designer where they just tailor an outfit to suit an individual, or you go into bridal, you know, you're just, you know, doing the service, the bridal service, or you go into ready-to-wear, or you go into production. So at the end of the day, you know, they're able to carve a niche for themselves. So I do bespoke. Now, I play with a lot of beads, so they're also going to learn bead and stoning. I play with a lot of beads, just that the outfit I'm wearing is really simple. But if you come to the office, you see that we actually customize fabric from scratch, and then we transform it. So I can spend about 3 months just producing one outfit, but that is my market. So if you want to, if you want my service, you know, you have to give me minimum like 2 months and above if you want just one piece. But that is my market. So that is why I'm creating the designers, you know, that can attend to, you know, other services that people want.
So you're training in this sort of couture line
as well.
So you have a proper atelier.
Yes. We have a curriculum that they follow.
When you look at the fashion industry in Nigeria, what is your hope for the fashion industry, and where do you feel that the industry is going?
I think the fashion industry is, I think they're beginning to recognize the fashion industry, and the fashion industry is actually very lucrative. I mean, hundreds of people come monthly, you know, to come make inquiries.
Well, it sounds like it. I mean, yeah, just you're taking 2 months just, to make
yes,
up one
just,
piece.
Just to be a fashion designer. I went for an event recently, one Lagos summit or something, and then they were asking questions. Okay, so there was the question time, and 5 of the people that came out to ask questions were fashion designers. So I think the government should also, you know, start looking at the fashion sector and industry, yeah, and then, you know, support them because it's quite lucrative.
Where is the biggest need in the fashion ecosystem? Where should the government focus on when helping grow this industry?
I think the fashion academy first, because imagine, for the school fees, most people that come, they say it's expensive, just like the foundation student that cannot train, you know, that cannot afford it. So if the government partner with private sector like us, because the government can't do everything. So if they partner with private sectors like us that are already filling the space in creating, you know, training and then creating this employment, probably take off the tax or help with the, you know, with the power, okay, I think we would reduce the school fees. Thereby, more people can, you know, afford the school fees, and then thereby more people can also come and train. So I think maybe they should support the people that are trying to train first, and then from there, creating the funds for those that have gone through the training, you know, so that they can also get access to the loan and then start their own business, yeah.
So apart from the government, what can private individuals do to support your programs?
The same thing, really. I think they have some CSROs or program that they do. You know, send us candidates to train and then just support with maybe their kit. And that way we'll train more. I mean, the people that we have also trained that have started theirs, you know, by the time they partner with people like us, I'm sure, you know, we'll cover a lot of unemployment, you know.
Well, Kelechi, thank you so much for being on the show. We wish you all the best with your academy and foundation, and look forward to having you back.
Thank you so much.
Well done.
Thank you.